Arabs,
the womanizers,
the monsters,
those bin Laden, the ones to watch out for,
to surveil,
to remove,
to attack.
But actually, we're
the advocates,
the war winners, the bilinguals.
Hello,
hola,
bonjour, who attack?
Assalamu alaikum. We're the 4.0 students,
not a real student,
the star athletes.
But we're also the misunderstood, the ones to watch out for,
to
surveil, to remove, to attack. It's my first day of 10th grade. My first day of the hijab in public. This hijab that powered me from Kiran Makar, typical teen, to Kiran Makar, ambassador for all 1.6 billion Muslims.
March 21st, 2003,
fireworks thrown into a Palestinian family van.
Flames burned brighter than the rocket's red glare.
America, what are you celebrating?
April 6,
2004. A woman's hijab lifted up and she's verbally assaulted.
But she's dangerous.
Right?
She deserves this.
Right? Wait. But it's her body.
Right.
Women should be able to do what they want.
Right.
So you can show, why can't we conceal?
August 6, 2007.
A chemical bomb was thrown into a Palestinian mosque.
The bomb almost hit two Muslim Americans.
Imagine what could have happened.
Two mothers could have lost their sons.
Two men could have lost their lives.
But wait, America, you don't care about our protection because you're trying to protect yourself from us.
From me, I was on my way home from school. You decided to cross to the other side of the street. Was the surface I walked on too hot for you to come near? Did you know that your looks flamed the fire of insecurities within me?
August 24, 2010.
A taxi driver picks up Michael Enright, his first passenger of the day.
He thinks it'll be an average ride until he uttered the word
Muslim.
Michael Enright slashed the taxi driver's face. Not once.
Not twice. What a price to pay for the freedom of your rights.
What a price to pay for freedom of religion.
One promise to you, and you, and you.
And me?
What about me? My first day at school, and the only Muslim girl wearing the hijab. I can feel everyone's eyes razor sharp, their lips forming questions. Who knew curiosity could cut so deep? I just wanted to curl up in a corner.
February 10, 2010.
Imagine you're a Muslim. Going to your house of prayer and seeing the words, Muslim, go home, dripping in red paint on the white wall.
Go home, they said. Go home where?
The hospital I was born.
The city that I was raised.
We're not just Muslims.
We're American Muslims, equal in every way.
I heard the words roll off his tongue. You Muslims are the reason why the airport lines are so long, you bombers. He was drunk, but a drunk mind speaks a sober heart.
These are the things we see, hear, and experience daily.
And now you know of these.
Hidden crimes. Unheard voices.
Terror on Muslims.
Restless souls.
Guns and bullet holes.
Wake up, America. The enemy has always been here.
Thank you.